Now, Mr. Saunders, you have worked at Southern State for some period of time, correct?
Yes.
Up till then. How long did you work there?
Every one of my 9th year.
Is it so that every day when you went to work, you would go through a metal detector?
Yeah.
Yes.
And you would then be searched?
Yes.
And describe, if you would, how, let me withdraw that. You saw other COs go through the detector, correct?
Yes.
And you've seen other COs get searched?
Yes.
And did they search you the same way they searched other COs?
In a manner of speaking, I can't say as far as the physical part of how they searched them, but as far as the process that they went through, mm-hmm. I got searched the exact same way.
Okay. Were you ever asked to remove any item of clothing or equipment for the search?
No.
At any point, how many years you worked there?
It was going on my 9th year.
Okay. Had you ever been discovered to have taken anything, attempted to take anything to the jail that you weren't supposed to take?
No.
Did you ever take your lunch into the prison?
We're not allowed to bring outside food.
Were you allowed to bring anything from the outside?
No.
Do you know if there was a policy, back then that could subject you to a more thorough search at the discretion of the administration there?
If they feel as though they have reason to believe that you're doing something with a supervisor being present, they could.
And you were aware of that?
Yes.
Mr. Saunders, have you ever taken into the prison any tobacco?
Never.
Mr. Saunders, have you ever taken into the prison any K2?
Never.
Any marijuana?
Never.
There were occasions, as I understand, that you were in the sergeant's office in 6th year.
Yes.
And back then, there was no prohibition against that?
No.
And from time to time, is it so that you would have different inmates come into that unit?
Yes.
Into his office?
Yes.
Is it so that sometimes you would situate yourself in there? What, during your withdrawal, during your tour, was your job to walk around the entire time?
Yes.
And sometime during your tour, would you situate yourself in the sergeant's office?
Yes.
Would you have inmates come in and talk with you?
They need to talk to us. If I'm in the office, they need to talk to me, yes.
Is it so that you had what you might call an open door policy, you encourage inmates to come talk with you?
Yes.
Now, was Lacovian Shepherd one of those individuals who ever came in to talk with you while you were in the sergeant's office?
Yes.
Was John Small, did John Small ever come to the sergeant's office and talk to you?
Yes.
How many inmates are in the unit you were charged with supervising?
160.
Of the 160 inmates in that unit, what percentage would you say has at some point come and talk to you in the sergeant's office?
About 99%.
Did you talk with the Lacovian Shepherd more than you talked with anyone else?
Yes.
Why was that?
The Lacovian was my head cook.
You what?
My head cook.
Okay.
For the kitchen. Okay. Yeah, the kitchen. Mm-hmm. And the Lacovian is also the unit rep.
Okay. Me, what's the unit rep? What's one of his responsibilities, his unit rep?
They like to go between the officers and the inmate. Mm-hmm. So if there's a problem, if anything's wrong, the inmates would tell him, and then he would come and talk to us, his officers.
Okay. During any of those meetings, did you ever give anything to a Kobe and Chuck that you were exposed to?
Never.
Well, Mr. Saunders, why would the Kobe and Chuck and others be accusing you of this if you didn't do it?
Professor, I apologize for speculation.
Do you know why these individuals would be accusing you of something if you didn't do it?
I wasn't a very light officer down there. Mm-hmm.
What do you mean by that?
From things that was told to me.
By whom?
By inmates and other officers.
Okay.
I wasn't very light down there.
You weren't very liked by other staff?
Is yes.
Were you liked by inmates on unit 6?
Not really.
So you learned that you weren't liked. How'd you learn that?
They would just come talk to me. If a officer happened to be working with me, and we'd be sitting out there talking, they would just, we'd just start talking about it.
You know, you heard the testimony of Officer Robbins, who said you just sat there and didn't do anything when you bought Smalls. Is that typical of the kind of thing you would encounter?
Yes.
Is it so that if one correctional officer took action against an inmate and the other officer didn't assist, that officer who didn't assist could be disciplined? Is that correct?
Yes.
Did anyone ever talk with you about your not participating in that event?
No.
You ever been brought up on any charges for
no.
in connection with not participating in that event?
No.
But you did participate.
Yes, I did.
You did write a report.
Yes, I did.
But you heard the officer testify, you just sat there. That's not true, is it?
Yes, I heard.
Is that accurate?
No, that's not true at all.
Did Lacovey and Shepard ever give you contact information for Tasha Swain?
No.
You heard Lacovey and Shepard testify, and it seemed that he was upset with you about something. Do you know what that's about?
I have no idea.
You heard me ask her questions about whether she had ever gone out to lunch with you.
Yes.
And she said she had not, correct?
Yes.
Did she ever go out to lunch with you?
Yes.
When did she first go out to lunch with you?
The first time we went out was sometime, I want to say April, May of that year.
2017?
No, 2016.
Okay. And where was that? That
was Friends.
Friends located where?
Located Marlton.
Okay. Did you ever go out with her to lunch again?
Yes.
Let me ask you this, Mr. Saunders. Did you kind of like her?
Yes.
So you went out with her a second time. Where was that?
That place called Franklin's.
And where is that located?
That's located.
Is it in Cherryville?
No, nah, that's almost an East End.
Okay. Was there a time that you can you put an approximate date on that?
I know it was again in 2016. I can't be.
Okay, understood. Was there any other occasion you had gone out with her to have something to eat?
Yes, it was a place in Cherry Hill. I can't pronounce the name of it. It's like a Korean place.
On the occasions you, on the many occasions you met with Ms. Swain, was there ever an occasion where she came and sat in your car?
Yes.
There were occasions when you and she had some discussions about family and such.
Yes.
Did you ever disclose to Ms. Swain that you live with someone?
Yes.
And she disclosed some personal information to you as well?
Yes.
Correct? And that was about her daughter, who was a victim of domestic violence. That's how you learned that.
Yes.
And a friend in Florida.
Yes.
And you heard me ask her about whether you had ever loaned her any money. She said no. Remember that?
Yes.
Is that accurate?
No, it's not accurate at all.
During the time you worked at Southern States, was it known by the staff that drugs were coming in and out into Southern States?
Yes.
Were there investigations while you were there?
Yes.
Were there, what was believed to be the main way contraband is coming into the facility?
Visits.
By visits?
Yeah.
During the time you were there, were there visitors who were who brought contraband in?
Yes, that's where, as far as where they found the drugs in the female's bathroom and that light switch.
Let me ask you this. When an inmate comes to Southern States and they're assigned to a unit, let's suppose they have a 10-year sentence, they're assigned to a unit, how long would they be on that unit, Unit 6?
It all depends. They could, they go to things like classification where they can sit up here and they could be going to classification where they go out to the camps. Mm-hmm. So they can be there for, 2 months. They can be there for 2 years. They can be there for 5 years.
It's just no way to really tell.
Yeah, it's just no way to tell.
Now, you've been gone almost 2 years, correct?
Yes.
Do you know whether some of the same inmates are still on Unit 6? Do you have any way of knowing that?
No.
Do you believe some of the same inmates are on Unit 6?
Objection, Your Honor.
Now, Mr. Saunders, have you ever received in the mail any communication sent to you by an inmate or an inmate's family member?
Never.
And you've lived on Empire for how long?
About 18 years.
Empire Avenue.
Yes.
Now, you've read the discovery in this case, correct?
Yes.
And you've learned from reading that discovery that there was a confidential informant involved in this case, correct?
Yes.
And it's not disclosed in the discovery who the confidential informant is.
Objection on irrelevance, but there's a confidential informant.
There's been testimony about that. I'll let you develop it, Mr. Thompson, okay, and see where this
And there's a confidential informant involved in the case, correct?
Yes.
And the confidential informant provided information to the authorities based on what you saw in the study, correct?
Yes.
And you heard testimony from Tasha Swain that she went to meet this person, Rock, before she came to meet you that day. Is that correct?
Yes.
You know who Rock is?
No.
Do you know whether he was ever an inmate at Center State?
I have no idea.
Based on her testimony, is your understanding that he knows the Colby Shepherd?
That's what he said.
Just one more question.
Sure.
What I do, Judge, at this point, I'll offer into evidence the
medication request slips.
Yes, Judge. And I think
we'll give you the numbers.
You do?
No, I don't.
Okay. D8, 9, 10, 11, and 12.
D8, 9, 10. The objection.
No, Your Honor.
Now, Mr. Saunders, when you were arrested on the 20th, and you were taken to the police barracks in Belmont, correct?
Yes.
And you were taken there by whom, if you recall?
Detective Gerard.
And did he have, and you saw the interview he conducted was recorded.
Yes.
Both video and audio, correct?
Yes.
He explained to you that you had a right to remain silent, right?
Yes.
Why didn't you just remain silent?
He, while in the holding cell, he was making reference to me returning.
Protection, Your Honor, his answer is going to be hearsay. He's describing what the detective told him in the holding cell.
He's not what he was doing, Judge. He's telling what happened.
Are you going to say what the detective said to you?
Yeah, absolutely.
Was it your judgment rule?
It's hearsay. He said he was going to say what he said.
Was it your understanding after talking with Detective Englehart that if you cooperated, that was a way to ensure that you could go home that day?
Yes.
Is it not so that he talked with you before you started videotaping and explained to you that if you go in here and you just deny you did anything, that you probably won't go home?
Objection, Your Honor.
Sustained.
Was that your understanding?
Yes.
Well, objection, Your Honor. Just ask what was your understanding.
That's still hearsay. Was it, Detective Englehart is here to testify.
I'll rephrase it. Was it your understanding that if you talk to them, that you might get to go home?
Objection.
That understanding could only be based on
one. Can I be heard at sidebar, Judge?